With his first executive order, Governor Jared Polis sends a message about his priorities. He wants to push Colorado towards zero emissions.
And Denver 7's Jennifer Kowaleski is joining us. And Jen, the governor wants our state to move to 100% renewables by 2040. So how will that work?
Ann and Shannon, it's a bold mandate, but Polis has said from day one that that's what his administration is all about. Environmental groups are calling today's order a huge step forward for cleaner air and one that should give consumers more electric car options. But not everyone is buying it.
The time to act is now.
10 days into his new job as governor, Jared Polis is taking on Denver's brown cloud, signing his first executive order to put more electric cars on the road.
It's done.
The order calls for the state health department to establish a zero emissions program no later than May.
Zero emission vehicles clean our air today.
Colorado will join 10 other states across the country with these standards. A move Conservation Colorado says will give consumers more options to buy electric cars.
States that have adopted the zero emission vehicle standard are the ones where the companies are sending their widest range of options.
To put it in perspective, California consumers have 41 electric car models to choose from, while Colorado only has 25.
Subaru, kind of one of our iconic cars here in Colorado. You can't buy electric here, but you can in other states. Now we'll be able to.
Polis also redirected $70 million. Volkswagen paid the state as a part of its emissions scandal, solely to this effort. Money he wants to use to build out infrastructure, add more charging stations, and transition the state fleet to electric. While everyone was all cheers at the signing this morning,
we've all seen the Denver brown cloud, and now's the time to clean it up.
The Colorado Automobile Association says there's a reason you don't see electric vehicles pulling horse trailers or hauling six kids to their events. The association believes Coloradans don't need the government telling them what car to buy, while the Colorado Oil and Gas Association wants an opportunity to compete and let the best energy resource win. They also note wind and solar surely have a seat at the table, but let's not forget that even wind blades and solar cells are made from oil and gas. Now, under Hickenlooper's administration, the state's Air Quality Control Commission adopted a low emissions vehicle standards. Now, Conservation Colorado says this takes it to the next level and really sends a message that Colorado wants to be a leader in addressing climate change. For now, we're live in the newsroom. I'm Jennifer Kowaleski for Denver 7.
Jennifer, thank you.